jealous and upset because this girl I've never met I get to meet tonight at 8. I'm taking her to dinner at a charming old cafe, but who can eat tonight at 8? It's early in the morning and our date is not till 8 o'clock tonight, and yet already I can see what a nightmare this whole day will be. I haven't slept a wink, I only think of our approaching tête-à-tête tonight at 8. I feel a combination of depression and elation. What a stay to wait till late. 3 more minutes, 2 more seconds, 10 more hours to go. I know when this is done, if something's ended or begun, and if it goes all right, who knows, I might propose tonight at 8. I wish I knew exactly how I'll act and what will happen when we dine tonight at 8. I know I'll drop the silverware, but will I spill the water or the wine? Not tonight at 8. Tonight I'll walk right up and sit right down beside the smartest girl in town, and then it's anybody's guess. More and more I'm breathing less and less. In my imagination I can hear our conversation taking shape tonight at 8. I'll sit there saying absolutely nothing, or I'll jabber like an ape tonight at 8. 2 more minutes, 3 more seconds, 10 more hours to go. In spite of all I've written, she may not be very spinned at my hopes. Perhaps may all collapse kaput tonight at 8.
Chris Lorenke!
Yeah, Chris.
First time on the show. Welcome, Chris.
Thank you, thank you.
Good to be here. We're not done with you.
I know.
We're not done with you. This is your initiation.
Oh, it's initiation right this second?
You have to answer these 10 questions.
Perfect. No. Hit the mute. Well, hit me.
Hit the mute button.
Hit them on me.
Why don't we ask? Well, he's coming back, and when he comes back, we're gonna have a chat with Chris.
Okay.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Do it. That's fine.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's great to have him. Tonight's show is really, really, really going to be fun. It's a whole different show than the show that we started out to have tonight. Unfortunately, if those of you who are not here around us in the East Coast, you don't know that we are having horrific weather. This is our third day of torrential rain, today being the worst. And as I was heading here back from the shore, I strongly advised Abby not to even dare get on the road. She was coming back the furthest. And there she is with us, Abby. Yeah. We love you. We miss you. And you're here in spirit. And there's Christy. Well, Christy, you're the magic.
Now I'm looking at you, Bob, and you're like sitting so high. And we will never get this camera right.
I'm sitting so high. Okay, I can.
We're there. Now Christy and I are like the same. And you're like way up here.
Well, you can change that when I'm appearing with Christy. But then again, I could go back and do that. And now.
Oh, look at you. You're like life size.
We're almost all the same.
We've only been doing this for how many shows? 255. Yes, wow. It's written on the call sheet. 255.
Anyway, this is Christy Erickson for another first.
Oh, you just Christy.
We have Chris. So how about that? We have Chris, Christy, the first two singers, Chris and Christy.
And Christy, you're right here in Doylestown.
Yes.
So I always ask the question for, and I'm going to ask Chris this. So Chris, listen, I'm giving you like the advance notes, okay? When did you first start singing?
Are you asking me?
Can you remember? Like what was the point that got you up on stage for the first time or singing for the first time?
I was singing in the little kids' church choir.
Oh.
When I was like 7.
And it stuck.
Pretty much, yeah.
Have you been? And then now you're singing with a band, correct?
Yes.
What's the name of your band?
Funky Cowboys.
Funky Cowboys. Yep. Do you have a website or a place where people can go and find out?
We do. There's a Facebook page and there's an Instagram page. So check us out.
Funky Cowboys is like Funky Cowboys in Doylestown.
Funky Cowboys. That's correct.
Okay. Cool.
Yep.
Well, that's perfect for the song you picked first song today.
We actually do this with the band. Yeah.
You do this? Yeah. I love. There's a lot of Dolly Parton on the show.
So we have 3 Dolly Parton songs tonight.
Cool.
Which is pretty cool.
It is
and,
cool.
And what was the other theme? Oh, yeah, the other theme about tonight is that all three of our special guests tonight are people that you would see if you probably came if you came to a Friday night at Bowman's Tavern.
Sure. That's true.
It all turned out to be. And so Christy and Chris have never been on the show, but they've seen each other at Bowman's. And Megan's been there a lot. And so this is a little bit of our Friday night family.
But Christy
tonight.
Was looking pretty darn elegant the other night when I saw her last, you know, hanging out
oh,
with
yeah.
you.
That
piano.
Was really, really fun. So
she
I really
was at the River House.
That
the
was
River House.
Oh, my God, that was wonderful.
And Bob had a little stool set up there, and you were just like, you know, you were all dolled up. And you're just lying.
It was
there,
our friend
you know?
Sharon Popkin's birthday, yeah. so we had a it stool set up for her to yeah. sing a couple songs, so the mic was all ready for you.
Yeah. It's wonderful. We had a wonderful time.
Well, Christy Erickson.
All right.
Thank you so much.
I love that you're doing this song.
Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Please don't take him just because you can. Your beauty is beyond compare, with flaming locks of auburn hair and ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring, your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, there's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, Jolene. And I can easily understand how you can easily take my man. You don't know what he means to me, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 Jolene. Please don't take him just because you can. You could have your choice of men, but I could never love again. He's the only one for me, Jolene. I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do, Jolene. Jolene, 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 Jolene. I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, Jolene. Jolene, Jolene, please don't take him even though you can. Jolene, Jolene.
Yay.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Nice job, yeah. Christy.
Awesome, Christy. No, now, of course, that's a big song again because Beyonce dropped it on her new country album.
No,
yeah.
I don't know about that.
Well, you know. You never know. You never know.
I haven't heard it, so.
I haven't heard it yet. Dolly Parton said it's different, but she appreciates it. But then again, mm-hmm. Dolly Parton's getting residuals, so. You know.
True. I heard some other song she did, and I was like, no.
I don't know. I kind of, you know. Yeah. I'm open to all sorts of things. I'd rather hear a good country song than like a song that is has lyrics that I find to be a little.
Trite?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I agree.
And like
yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, you know, we'll see. We'll
and
see.
You know who's watching tonight, Christy? Our friend Rhoda Rogers, who
yeah,
introduced
Rhoda.
Us.
Rhoda.
Hi, Rhoda. Hi, Talent Rhoda. Scale.
She's sending her best, and there'll be more. Christy's going to come back.
And look at all the people
thanks,
watching
Christy.
Out
thanks,
there.
Guys.
We have Patricia down in South Jersey. I saw Vic's out there in Reno, and Jane is out there in London, and Lorelei, and Candace, and. Oh, wow, look at all these people I get to say hi to. And also, I want to wish my friend Candace Burke a happy birthday. It is her birthday today. And it's two also very special friends of ours, Bill Tomer, who's on the show quite often, or has been on the show quite often. Bill Tomer, it's his birthday tomorrow, as well as our dear friend Joan Nobiloni Maloney. So happy birthday, Joan. Happy birthday. And hi, Tony Ruggieri, and John Finley is with us, too. He sang with me last night down in Asbury Park. And Eileen Scheibner, Patty Clark, Dustin Tam's with us, too. Michelle Mercado and Frank Chimkin. And Ed McLaughlin down there in North Carolina. Jimmy Two Canes, Sharon Freeman, John Ward. And Patricia in South Jersey, I already mentioned that, Patricia's store. Christina Freeman was originally supposed to be with us tonight, but she'll be with us in 2 weeks for our Sondheim show. So there you have it. So tonight's going to be a little bit of this, a little bit of that. We've got some Broadway tonight. We have a song by Pink. We have John Legend, Cyndi Lauper, Peter Allen, and maybe some other surprises along the way. Anyway, so shall we move along? Because we have back. We have Megan Eckerson.
Megan Eckerson.
Long time no see.
She's back. You were just here like not quite a month ago.
No, I don't think, yeah, I was going to say not too long ago. Yeah. I was back here in this very spot.
Yeah, maybe a little bit further that way. Actually, can you take a little step to the... Yes, perfect. and turn your microphone a little bit with you? So it's head on? Yes, see, you know, you got it.
Always fixing the text.
I know. So how are you? How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing pretty good.
I see you almost every Friday. And you've been working at MacArthur Theater.
I sure am. If you come by MacArthur Theater, I'll probably make you a drink before your show. So, oh.
So I got a question. Were you there this past weekend when who was there this past?
John Stewart.
John Stewart.
Oh, boy, was I.
They had three sold-out shows.
They did. It was two shows on Friday, and then it was one show on Saturday. I was up in the balcony on the two-show day making everybody's margaritas, and they had like a central, they had like a theme drink for him, too. So it was
so
a whole thing.
Do they sell more drinks for a comedian than they do a, like, you know, a,
I think
a
I
regular concert act?
I think it's the same amount of like specialty cocktails, but like people come at you with some very odd things, and you know, just sometimes you just gotta work with it.
I'll have to ask you offline what the oddest thing someone is, because this is a family show.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah. What are you singing, Megan?
So I'm singing History of Wrong Guys from a little show called Kinky Boots.
Kinky Boots.
Kinky yeah. Boots. And have you seen Kinky Boots?
I unfortunately did not get to see it. I did watch it on the whatever it is, the slime tutorials, the kids call it, where it's like the shows are on YouTube.
Yes, you can see it on Broadway HD.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, because sometimes you miss it, you know?
You know, and it's Kinky Boots, of course, was a movie from the UK.
Yes.
That became a musical with Cyndi Lauper, and who wrote the music lyrics and won a Tony for it, along with, what's his name, with the voice, Harvey Firestein. Oh, wine, Firestein.
What?
Fire scene. Get that wrong. Anyway, so anyway, and Jerry Mitchell directed it, and it ran for several years. So
yeah.
Here you go with the History of the Wrong Guys from Kinky Boots.
Oh, no. Don't you dare. Girl, girl, girl. I'm warning you. Oh, I think I have a crush. I can't. I think I'm falling for him. Choices since the beginning of time. Are you gonna be another one of mine? I used to think you were from outer space. Who's that bright-eyed guy in your place? You're kind of cute when you're not so shy. But I've been here before. Have I come back for more? Another chapter in the history of wrong guys. You used to be silly, a limp, lackluster bore. But now you're changing into something I just can't ignore. Joy, honestly, I've been on like this before. Star-crossed lover, we all know how that ends. I'm better off without him. We're better off as friends. the girl next door. 5 loves the boy next door. 6 don't love you no more. Makes you insecure. Makes you so unsure. Is so immature. Loves his mother more. Or has a girlfriend named Nicola.
Eckerson.
How fun.
Thank you, Megan.
I think it's, as Chris is getting ready to come up and sing again, I think it's so funny that you're doing something from, I love how threads work in these shows, because when I think of Kinky Boots, I always think of one night at the Asbury Hotel probably 5-6 years ago when Chris, who's in the show tonight, and Jonathan Jacob, one of our other singers, were both going to auditions or callbacks. For Kinky Boots, and you came in wearing them. Mm-hmm. Isn't that right, Chris?
Yeah, no, you're not wrong. They look good, too.
They look good. Mm-hmm. They came in, and everyone's like, what's that all about? Mike, they have auditions for Kinky Boots.
Amazing.
That was a lot of fun. It was a fun night. Look at all the people watching out there as we're on. Dottie Rudnick and Rich Lentowski's out there, too, I saw. And Phil Zipkin and Carol Tribaro and Mary Helen Morris in Texas. Tyler, Texas. Beth Hansen, Bill Salder. Amy Robideau's with us too, and Jim Nichols, and Penny Katz,
and
Judy Jones.
There you go, and bring the microphone with you. Boom. It's so hard because we're all different sizes.
Mm-hmm. That is really true tonight.
Tonight, yes, and I'm like looking at it going, I gotta move the camera. And plus I'm feeling rusty, we haven't done this in 2 weeks.
Well, and Christian has, you know, separation anxiety now that he misses that, right, Christian? Hi, Christian.
Absolutely. I don't know what to do on Wednesdays anymore.
On the middle Wednesday.
Somehow
I just cry.
Kids fill the time.
I feel like on the middle Wednesday, I need
they
to
do.
Send you like hearts or send you love just to let you know you're not out of mind, just out of sight.
I mean, you can do that on a Tuesday if you'd like.
All right. Hi, Christian. Thanks for being with us. You Thanks, do such Christian. An amazing job week after week after week after week, and we're so blessed to have you.
I'm going to have you step into the microphone because I'm going to ask you some questions,
Chris.
Chris.
Like,
you hello, heard, hello. The, you check, heard check. The question. You heard the question.
Uh-oh. Yes.
So when did you start singing?
So I've always been singing. My parents kind of really helped me out with it. They always encouraged it. I did choir. I grew up with sports mostly, but I was always singing on the side. So
what
like,
was your sport?
Baseball.
Okay.
And I love football, too. And then in high school, they kind of made me decide what I wanted to do. They pulled a Troy Bolton on me from High School Musical, I guess. And they were like, which one do you want? And I was like, I love singing so much more. I've been doing it longer, just naturally. And so I went to school for it. I went to school for theater at Fairleigh Dickinson. And ever since then, I've just been doing more and more. I've been singing. I took a little bit of a break, so I'm very happy to be back singing. Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Michael.
You're welcome. And you're sounding great. And you're out auditioning and doing things now, right? So you're trying
yes.
to... Anything coming up? Any projects, concerts, things that you're working on?
This was my most recent project, so I'm so happy to be here. So we're going to include this one.
And every week you come out with a new song, so I'm really appreciative of that, too. So that means you're working on some material. And this, I don't know if I heard you sing this one yet. I
think this tonight, one?
Yeah.
You're ready for it.
I'm ready.
It's a good one.
I'm ready.
Prepare yourself. Prepare
yourself.
Let me just get my little cough drop thing going while I say hi to a couple people. Can you get ready for the song? David Mayoko's out there. David
he is out
Mayoko.
There.
He started out with us on this virtual thing 4 years ago.
He still crops up and does some shows. You should subscribe
the
to his
amazing performer.
Follow him, yes, if you're not
and
following.
His Liberace is mm-hmm. unbeatable, the best.
Yes.
Hi, David. And Vincent's out there in Chicago. And Paul Bressy and Michael Lemmy.
Yeah.
Good to have you with us tonight.
Yeah. Nice to see them out there.
I like it. See, Chris, it's your fan club.
Yeah,
our
I love
fan
it.
Club,
thank
right?
you all. Thank you.
I love it. All right, guys.
All right, Chris Loreski.
I'm in love with you. This ain't a honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. We're right in the thick of love. At times we get sick of love. It seems like we argue every day. I know I've misbehaved. We've made weird mistakes. And we both still got room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I'll still put you first. But I think we should make this work. And we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, this time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. This time we'll take it slow. This ain't a movie, no. No fairy tale conclusion, y'all. It gets more confusing every day. Oh, sometimes it's heaven sent. Then we head back to hell again. We kiss and we make up on the way. I hang up, you cold. We rise and we fall. And we feel just like walking away. As our love advances, we take second chances. Though it's not a fantasy, I still want you to stay. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, this time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, this time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Maybe we'll live and learn. Maybe we'll crash and burn. Maybe you'll stay. Maybe you'll leave. Maybe you'll return. Maybe another fight. Maybe we won't survive, but maybe we'll grow. Maybe you'll know, baby, you and I. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. We're just ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. 'Cause we're ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. Take it slow. Oh, this time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. This time we'll take it slow. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Oh, this time we'll take it slow.
Chris Lorenke.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nice.
Beautiful. Beautifully done.
Thank you.
Lots of nice comments.
Hi, Bill Pappas. See. Good to see you, too. Bill
likes
it, too.
Thank you. You'll be back again.
Love it. Oh, seriously. Yeah.
You'll be back.
He'll be back.
Oh, my God. Did we just give it away?
Maybe. So, but you know, while you're getting ready for the next song, I just want to say that we're running short, right? So that means that, you know what that means, Bob. You get to do a solo, and the audience gets to pick something for me to sing. That's what it means. So if you have something you want me to sing, put it in the chat. Christian's going to take care of them and keep track of them.
And if Jane Steffens has something she wants me to play as a piano solo, let me know too.
I think
I see she's out there.
So anyway, so put them in the chat.
It's nice to have you out there, Paul and Michael. Mm-hmm. And my God, a lot of new people tonight. I like this.
Yeah.
So also, as Megan's getting ready, I want to thank you all for continuing your support for our show, the Venmo, PayPal thing. We really do take seriously because we only do the show every other week, but the expenses are all the same. The overhead is the same, and we don't ever want to not do this show. It's just too much fun, and it's so wild after a couple weeks to like look back and see that like some of the shows recently, 1,000 people watched the show. Yeah. It was wonderful.
It's fun to go back, isn't it? Did you see there's amazing. A comment, actually.
Hi, Beverly. Hi, John Ward.
There's a comment from Vincent Duradio who says, Christian, why don't you host some replays on the off weeks?
You know, that's other people have said the same thing.
If Christian selects, I can only imagine what he would select.
Oh, my God.
I can only imagine. Like, Christian, oh, you should see. He's on the screen going like this right now. Like, that's you should too much see power. Him. Oh, my God. Yeah, too much power in the hands of Christian. Does anyone really trust Christian?
You know what it could be? Christian could do a show without us. He could do a show of, like, you know what? Famous, like, the highs and the lows.
Christian, I have a great idea. You can do it as a podcast. So you could be commenting on the shows. Like, yes. Can you imagine?
I was telling Amy that that's like my dream is to host like a karaoke bar type of a setting where I get to be like Simon Cowell, like old school Simon Cowell. And just if you don't leave crying, I haven't done my job correctly.
But can you picture it? You could like be playing like I don't know one of my performances, and you could be saying, "Well, here comes the money note. Here it comes." Oh, ooh, I wouldn't do that.
Just
missed it.
I would be the Paula Abdul and just say how nice you look tonight.
Then we know he's lying, ladies and gentlemen. But back for more is Egan. Is Megan? Megan Eckerson. See what you did to me.
Oh my God.
So while we're getting ready, we had a couple requests. Michael, my sister asked for Ribbon in the Sky, but I don't think you know that.
No, wasn't that her wedding song?
It was her wedding song. Yeah. And Michael and Bennett are out there, Bennett Lee, nice. And his dad, Michael Aniloff. I see Beverly's out there. Hi, Beverly Torsolari. And George and Donna. And anyway,
Christian will go through and maybe star those for me so I can read them.
Yes. Well, zero in on a request because we're done this. Is this an audience choice for you, Michael? Is that what that is?
For me and then you, of course. But I think we know what you're gonna do.
I know. I love it anyway. I know. I love it all.
Megan, what have you got for us this time?
Oh, this time. So this is one actually. I don't think I've like actually performed before, and like so. I'm doing "Get Out and Stay Out," which is initially a Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton.
I know. I'm one of the Dolly Parton people. Yeah.
Megan Eckerson.
Well, it's funny how you waltzed in here, assuming I'd come back. Well, let me tell you something. You are way off track. Can't you see I'm different? Or are you still that blind? No, you stand right there and take it. There's no love to hide behind. Well, I am proud to tell you I'm really feeling good. I'm doing so much better than you ever thought I would. Got my own place and my own space to think and dream and plan. Took me this long to realize I do not need a man. I used to need you, but then I finally learned. I used to want you, but now the tables turned. I used to love you, now it's your time to squirm. I'm saying goodbye and I won't wait for your return. So get out and stay out. I've finally had enough. abused me. You cheated and you lied. So get out and stay out. I'm taking back my life. My life.
Megan Eckerson.
Yeah.
Oh, Megan. Great job.
Megan, I just want to make the observation. Can we do that again with a little more feeling? I want to make the
observation that the first song was kidding. A girl who was begging like for a relationship with the right guy.
Yeah.
And this song was somebody says, get the
get out of here. Yeah.
That was not intentional, I swear. But
I sense a theme here tonight.
Yeah, seriously. Thank you, Megan. Thank you. And that, absolutely. Of course, was Dolly Parton from 9 to 5, the musical.
Dolly.
Dolly more Dolly.
Megan and Taking Steps. Oh, yeah.
Where was my thing?
Book? Wow. So surprising.
So last night when I was playing in Asbury Park, one of the women sang an amazing rendition of I Will Always Love You. Mm. And my wonderful sound guy, Jason Portizo, sent me this meme. It said, Dolly Parton. Writing I Will Always Love You and Jolene on the same day is mind-blowing. It would be like, this is hysterical, it would be like if Da Vinci finished the Mona Lisa and then turned around in the same day and wrote Jolene. I didn't get that at first, and I went, oh, that's really funny.
I have to say that when I'm looking at the call
sheet. Hi, Tom Chiola.
I'm looking at the call sheet, and we have an Erickson and an Eckerson.
No, I thought the same.
I know, we have.
And every time I look at it, I'm like,
we have Chris and Christy, we have Erickson and Eckerson. And you wonder why I get tongue-tied.
And you wonder why I get tongue-tied too, exactly. Well, so, just, I know you're going to play something on the piano first, but I want to go through some of these, you know. Christian has, yes, because I got to figure out what I'm doing. But Christian has listed a bunch of songs that people have written in for me to sing. So I'm just going to go down the list, Bob, and you can kind
of
like...
Are you going to go down that list in front of me or while I'm
playing?
I'm going
to go down the list in front of you, and then I'll... Because I'm going to need a minute to get myself together while you play. So, of course, Eileen Scheibner wants Edelweiss, but put a pin in that, Eileen. We'll come back to that at some time.
We do that a lot.
We've done it. Phil Zipkin says, Don't Rain on My Parade, which I know he's suggesting because he did it on a Wheel show.
Uh-huh.
Brilliantly, by the way. Tomorrow is in here twice. Rhoda Rogers and I've never sung Tomorrow from Annie. Easter Parade. Christina Freeman wants me to sing People. Jimmy Toucane says, You'll Never Walk Alone. Vincent Maisano says, This Guy's in Love with You. It's a good song. I should work on that. That's What Friends Are For, Jane Stevens. We're going to get to that in a second. Up Where You Belong, Ribbon in the Sky. Anything Cole Porter, says Bev Torsilleri. Anything Michelle Legrand, says Jay LaDan.
Abby seconds that Don't Rain My Parade. And Paul Bressy says Corner in the Sky.
Corner in the Sky. Say a Little Prayer. And It Only Takes a Moment is in there. And there's a request for you to play and sing. Walking My Baby Back Home, just saying.
Karen Clayton must have asked for that, Karen.
No, that was Dottie Rudnick.
Dottie.
And On a Clear Day You Can See Forever. And Tom Sheila says Losing My Mind. Put a pin in that one, Tom. I'll come back to that at some point. Billy Joel, You're My Home. Of course I could do that. Anything Sondheim, but we have a Sondheim show coming up, Marcy, so you'll have to come back to hear what we're doing.
Two weeks from tonight, we're celebrating Stephen Sondheim. So, and it's a Sondheim. I call it a Sondheim Festival because we're only doing one show, so there's like 10 singers each doing one song.
We're stuffing it with a lot of music, yeah.
You'll hear Terry Fenningham, Patti Leone, Christina Freeman.
So I'll let you think about what do you think out of that list, Egan?
I like everything on the list, but there's probably like 6 that stand out, like certainly Corner in the Sky. What were some of the early ones?
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow's?
People. Never Walk Alone.
Which one?
You'll Never Walk Alone. You know, Tomorrow might be fun. We've never done
it. Tomorrow might be a lot of fun.
It was on here
because
twice.
We need it. The sun will come out tomorrow.
That's Please. Why people are suggesting it, not because they see me in a wig with a red dress. maybe we'll do that. That could be fun. But you're going to play something in the meantime, right?
And maybe, if we have time, we'll do two.
Okay.
We'll see. Let's just see how I feel about
that. What are you going to play? All right,
Jane. Jane, so when I was doing, Jane and I had a conversation like last week Jane is over in the UK, yes. And Jane said that her favorite moments through COVID were when I used to do these Zoom things in the morning, and these Facebook things for the cancer patients up in Summit and Morristown Memorial. Since we couldn't be at the hospital, we had a lot of them tune on and watch, you know, the songs that I used to play on the mornings when I would play for them all. And our theme song of those mornings, of which Jane, because it was, you know, it was afternoon for her. She wouldn't have to stay up late like tonight. So our theme song for the end of every show was this. And she said, you know, that made me very happy through those times of COVID. And I would love to hear that. So.
Sounds good. Bob Egan. Aileen says wowsy. Aileen, your sister says wowsy.
She said lousy?
Wowsy.
Oh, wowsy.
Wowsy, bro. Wow, wow, wow.
Thanks, Aileen.
Those piano lessons paid off.
Those piano lessons, yes. The nuns in grade school.
The nuns in grade school. All right, so we can try this, all right? So now...
Oh, we are doing that.
We are going to do it. Yeah, we're going to try it. Sure,
oh, boy.
Now, we have not rehearsed this, and we never talked about an arrangement. Let's just try to lay it back a little bit, and then we'll build to something. And you choose the key.
I think I'm going to do the original.
All right. Okay.
Anyway, so Chris, I think there's a red wig in the back storage thing.
I might need it. Of course. Of course, you know, Amy Robidoux's out there saying that she has one.
She does have one. And I don't, and sometimes she leaves her props behind, but this wasn't one of them.
No, this was not one of them. This was never a song on my radar, so.
Yeah, let's see. Let me see.
But thanks to Eileen O'Neill Stahl, Aileen O'Neill Stahl, and somebody else recommended it.
Yeah, I think I'm going to do the original K. I think it's just fine.
Stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say this. Well, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come on, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come on, man. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. You're always a day away. Tomorrow, tomorrow,
we made that up, yes.
First were longer than I almost went into this.
Almost went into it. We'll see.
All right.
We'll see. We've done that a lot.
Oh, so we got to move on. Hi, Cousin Patty down there in Florida. And Kevin Callahan's with us, too. Love that. Thanks, Kevin.
Yeah.
Nice surprise. I miss seeing you. All right, we got to move on. We have more show. We've got Christy Erickson coming back. We have four more songs left in the show.
Christy Erickson. I gotta get this in my head. Of course, now I need to fix the camera because it's in wrong height.
Hold on.
Take me out, Christian.
Take you off. Yes. Oh, so I also wanted to say hi to the Jekylls, to my dear friend Jean, and Happy and Sam Shipley, and Ted and Kathy, and Rose and Joan. I already said hi to Joan because it's your birthday tomorrow. And C.G. Crescente, Julie Polanowski. And Andy and Mary Ann, never miss. Same with Dan and Dee and Jay and Peg. And my other sisters, Kathleen and Mary Ann. Because they, even if they're not here right now, I know they'll tune in at some point.
You know all these like new studios don't have camera people anymore? They're all robotic. That's what we need here. I need to be able to press a button and have it go up and down. That's why we need the you know, Venmo and PayPal.
More kids.
We have Christian.
We work hard. Yeah, we work hard. So, what are you Oh, you are doing a pink song.
I love this song.
For the first time ever. Everyone.
I do love this song. This is a great song. It's actually my favorite pink song, Christy Erickson.
Thanks, guys.
just your hands. Closed your eyes and trusted, just trusted. Have you ever thrown a fistful of glitter in the air? Have you ever looked fear in the face and said, I just don't care? It's only half past the point of no return, the tip of the iceberg, the sun before the burn, the thunder before the lightning, and the breath before the phrase. Have you ever felt this way? Staring at the phone, whole life waiting on the ring to prove you're not alone. Have you ever been touched so gently you had to cry? Have you ever invited a stranger to come inside? It's only half past the point of oblivion, the hourglass on the table, the walk before the run, the breath before the kiss, and the fear before the flames. Have you ever felt this way?
Christy Erickson.
That was fantastic.
That
was
beautiful. This is your first time.
That's the first time.
You're going to put that in your repertoire. That was great.
Yeah, I'd like to do it again.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, Christy. I'm so glad you made it here tonight.
Thank you so much for having
so
me.
Yeah, so good to meet you.
Really a great time with all you wonderful people.
Welcome to the family.
We do. We have three wonderful guest singers
in the
house tonight. Thank you.
Your worst nightmare.
Thanks.
She'll be back. You'll see Christy one more last time. We get Chris Lorenkin.
We do get Chris. And this song that he's going to do, I have heard him do before, I have to admit. But it's a great song. You know, it's from the musical Hamilton, and it's the only song usually sung by a white male. If that makes any sense. Everything else in the Hamilton's about immigrants. This is not, and it's a great song. I have to fix your camera. Hold on.
And it was so fun to see Jonathan Groff, who originated the role with the song, and to see him in the lead of Merrily We Roll Along twice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow, what a, an amazing actor. And so night and day, you know, in both roles. And Rachel Wyfall loved your song, Chris.
And you're gonna pull, squeeze and pull that up, Chris.
All right.
You know, yeah, there you go.
I should have gone to Burger King and gotten you one of those.
You need a little crown. You know, and Amy has one of those too, just saying.
Amy's got everything. Chris Lorenko.
You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in the tea which you hurled in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. You say your love is draining and you can't go on. You'll be the one complaining when I am gone. And no, don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject. My sweet, submissive subject, my loyal, royal subject, forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war for your love, for your praise. And I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. 'Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Now everybody. Da 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 da.
Lorenke.
Thank you.
That
song's so much fun to sing.
Oh, how Chris, much fun is that song? I heard them all singing at home. Phil Zipkin's going da 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 da.
Well, you know Bill is.
Oh, great song, my Chris. God. Chris, it's such a treat to finally have you on the show. This won't be the last. I know you're going to come back in a couple weeks and
he'll
do
be back.
A Billie Eilish song for us on the show. Ashley Wayne Barlow's watching also, and he said, great job. Great job. All right, Michael, it is your turn. It is what we call, officially, Michael time.
This was the song we had planned to do tonight. A Peter Allen tune. I heard this recently. I thought, oh, we should do this. It's a really pretty song. And this is one of the few songs that Peter Allen actually wrote for himself.
Yes. And we've never done this.
We've never done this.
And
we didn't do it before tonight.
And the music was hard to find. So
yeah, I was wondering about if some of that's in the rights, right? Because obviously, it's in one book, but it's not published in any of the typical sites. So there must be a rights issue with this. But it's a beautiful song. I love this song.
And I just, happen to have a copy of it. So here we go. Peter Allen.
Everywhere I go, I'm followed by a lot of people. Such a lot of people. It's almost up and red. And if you could see all the people, they're everyone I ever was and everyone I ever will be. All the lies of me, nothing left to go hide. I come in many colors, assorted shapes and sizes, can adapt to your demand. And if you smile at someone, then I'll just become that one and throw in all the others for free. All the lies of me. Faults aren't things for hiding on a shelf. And if you like who I am now, that's only a reflection of yourself. All the games are gone, we face each other naked, stripped of all disguises, and love is being made. And if I make you feel tall, after knowing all you know is really only all that you see, all the lives of me. If you can see all the people, everyone I ever was and everyone I ever will be, all the lives of me, all the lives of me.
Nice job, Michael.
Thanks, Bob. You too.
What a beautiful song. I've never done that. I've always loved that song. Isn't that the opening song of Boy from Oz?
I think it may be.
I think it is. Yeah. Beverly was watching. She loves Peter Allen. David Rickle, happy birthday also. It was his birthday the other day. And let's bring everybody up.
Oh, I know.
Because if we're going to do Dolly Parton, can you imagine we would possibly leave you without finishing with this song?
Oh, my God.
And Karen Clayton, happy birthday in advance. She has a big birthday coming up on Saturday. And we send all our love here, too. You have never missed a show either. And so we're going to send off with a little bit of Dolly.
Stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition, and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the street, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me with a job from 9 to 5.
You're
step on the boss man's ladder, but you got dreams he'll never take away. In the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll you away.
Working nine to five.
Thank you all for being with us tonight. Thank you for celebrating live music, great music. Thank you, Michael, for everything. Thank you, Megan and Christy and Chris. Thank you. It's just so much fun to celebrate such great musical artists like Dolly and so many other people tonight. Love you guys. See you in 2 weeks as we celebrate Stephen Sondheim. Thank you, Christian. We love you. Take care. Have a good night.